When a chicken sees its eggs being taken, why doesn't it get angry? If you snatch eggs right in front of a hen, she'll cluck furiously and peck at you. But if you take those eggs and leave a handful of cracked corn in exchange, she settles down. It's much like a rancher taking the fruits of a horse's or a cow's labor, but paying them with a fresh bale of hay thin, the livestock quietly go back to grazing. Here's what's really happening inside the hen's reproductive strategy. Chickens lack external genitalia like mammals, so during mating, the rooster's sperm is stored inside the hen's oviduct for up to 2.5 weeks. Any egg she lays during that window can be fertilized, so she maximizes her chances by laying as many eggs as possible. The hen has no way to tell whether a laid egg is fertilized. All she tracks is quantity. Until she's laid a threshold number of eggs in her nest, she won't settle down to incubate. If a few eggs disappear, whether to a fox, a crow, or a well-meaning farmer collecting breakfast, she simply enters egg replacement mode and lays more to reach her target clutch size. She never goes hunting for the missing eggs. She just keeps laying. Farmers have exploited this clutch size bug for centuries. If you clear out every last egg, the hen abandons that nest and looks for a new, safer spot. But if you leave even one decoy exe, a ping pong ball or an oval river pebblite tricks her into thinking the clutch is still incomplete. She keeps laying around that decoy anchor egg, often indefinitely. That's why experienced egg collectors always leave a single scout egg in the nest. Why are chickens so obsessed with topping up their clutches? Blame the dinosaurs. Modern paleontology traces the chicken's lineage back some 150 million years to Jurassic-era theropods like Archaeopteryx, meaning, technically, dinosaurs never truly vanished. In those prehistoric days, many small carnivorous dinosaurs survived by raiding nests. If an egg got stolen, the best defense wasn't retrieval, it was reproduction. Lay more eggs. Over millions of years, natural selection hardwired this one stolen, one replaced strategy into birds' DNA. In ecological terms, chickens follow an R-selected life history. High reproductive rate, low investment per offspring. They produce many eggs quickly, accepting that most won't survive, but ensuring the species persists. Today, domestic chickens are entwined with human civilization. As long as people keep farming them, they'll thrive. From a gene's eye view, that's a spectacular evolutionary success. Global distribution, billions of individuals, and a partnership with another dominant species. Selective breeding has only intensified this. On commercial poultry farms, a modern broiler chicken can convert roughly 1.6 pounds of feed into 1 pound of meat in just 6 weeks. Yet, those same birds may spend their entire lives confined to a space no larger than a sheet of A4 paper. By human standards, their existence is grim. By genetic logicite and reproduce, they're perfectly fulfilled. Intelligence, mobility, sensory richness, these are luxuries, not necessities, for the carbon-based life form that is Gallus gallus domesticus. Globally, we consume around 70 billion chickens each year-round chicken, every 0.05 seconds. Yet their genes have colonized every continent, and as long as humans keep farming them, chickens will continue their relentless egg-laying engine. Who's exploiting whom, the chicken or the farmer? It's a symbiosis written in DNA, a rural pact as old as domestication itself. In the end, the hen isn't angry. When her eggs vanish, she's simply driven by an ancient evolutionary program to replace them. And as long as that program runs, we can harvest her eggs sustainably, provided we leave that one little anchor egg behind.